Our fascination with space is endless and as old as our species began to think and wonder about the mysteries of the natural world. Astronomy in Greek literally means the science that studies the law of the stars. It's a natural science that studies celestial objects and phenomena, using mathematics, physics, and chemistry in order to explain their origin and evolution. In this video, we will take a virtual space tour of the solar system, find out how the Sun was formed, visit the terrestrial planets, the asteroid belt, the gas giants, the ice giants, visit Pluto, and the Oort cloud, unveiling the mysteries that make up our solar system.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, ignition, liftoff, 30 minutes.
Even though humanity has been thinking about and dreaming about exploring space for a very long time, we've been able to set foot on a celestial body other than Earth only in the last 50 years, making progress and expanding the frontier of space in this last half of a century more than in all of history of our species. But how did it all begin? How did the solar system form that eventually spawned life, which contemplates its own existence? About 4.5 billion years ago, a giant rotating cloud of gas and dust called a solar nebula collapsed because of its overwhelming gravity. The nebula started spinning faster and faster, and it flattened into a disk, pulling most of the materials towards its center, forming what we now call the Sun. The Sun is a yellow dwarf star at the heart of our solar system. Its gravity holds the solar system together, keeping everything from the biggest planets to the smallest particles of debris in its orbit. The Sun's enormous mass is held together by gravitational attraction, producing immense pressure and temperature at its core, which is about 50 million degrees Celsius, hot enough to sustain thermonuclear fusion. Like all stars, the Sun will someday run out of energy. When the Sun starts to die, it will get so big that it will engulf Mercury, which is our next stop. Mercury, the closest planet to the Sun and the smallest planet in our solar system, is only a bit larger than our Moon. The first terrestrial planet from the Sun has a very thin atmosphere, mostly composed of oxygen. On Mercury, temperatures can reach up to 430 degrees Celsius, so if you plan to visit this rocky planet, you would have a very long day, literally. A solar day lasts 176 Earth days, while it takes 88 Earth days for Mercury to make a complete orbit around the Sun. Despite its proximity to the Sun, Mercury is not the hottest planet in our solar system. That title belongs to the goddess of love and beauty, Venus. Similar in size and structure to Earth, Venus has been called Earth's twin. But these worlds are far from being twins. Venus has a thick, toxic atmosphere filled with carbon dioxide, and is perpetually shrouded in thick, yellowish clouds of mostly sulfuric acid that trap heat, causing a runaway greenhouse effect. Living up to at least one expectation of Roman mythology, Venus is the hottest planet in our solar system. Venus has longer days than years. One day on Venus lasts 243 Earth days, because the planet spins backwards, where the Sun rises in the west and sets in the east. Next up, we have the third rock from the Sun, and the only astronomical object known to harbour life, Earth, our home planet. But Earth wasn't always suitable for life. It has a violent, distant past. In the geologic eon, named Hadean, Earth was a hellish world, hostile to life as we know it. The Hadean eon began with the formation of Earth about 4.6 billion years ago, and according to the giant impact hypothesis, an ancient planet named Theia collided with an early Earth. with some of the resulting ejected debris gathering to form what is today the Moon. Geological history is a constant reminder that we need to become a multi-planetary species, and the most suitable candidate planet to do that is the last terrestrial planet from the Sun, Mars. It is a dusty, cold desert world with a very thin atmosphere, and is one of the most explored bodies in our solar system. Mars is the only planet where we've sent rovers to explore its landscape. Robotic explorers have found lots of evidence that the red planet was much wetter and warmer, with a thicker atmosphere, billions of years ago. This is the first high-resolution colour image to be sent back by the hazard cameras on the underside of NASA's Perseverance Mars rover after landing on February 18, 2021. After Mars, there are no more rocky planets in our solar system, but the space beyond the orbit of the red planet is occupied by a great many solid, irregularly shaped bodies, of many sizes but much smaller than planets, we call asteroids. This region is known as the asteroid belt. To give a perspective of how large or small these asteroids are, the total mass of the asteroid belt is approximately 4% that of the Moon. Close encounters with Mars or other objects change the asteroids' orbits, knocking them out of the main belt and hurling them into space in all directions across the orbits of other planets. Stray asteroids and asteroid fragments slammed into Earth and the other planets in the past, playing a major role in altering the geological history of the planets and the evolution of life on Earth. Luckily for us, we have a cosmic big brother named Jupiter, with a massive gravitational attraction, keeping most asteroids in check. Jupiter is the fifth planet in line and the first gas giant from the Sun. It is by far the largest planet in the solar system, more than twice as massive as all the other planets combined. Jupiter's stripes and swirls are actually cold, windy clouds of ammonia and water, floating in an atmosphere of hydrogen and helium. Its legendary Great Red Spot is a giant storm, bigger than Earth, and has been raging for hundreds of years. Jupiter is a ringed world with more than 75 moons. One of them is Europa, that could have a water ocean beneath the icy surface, harbouring extraterrestrial life. The sixth planet from the Sun is the second gas giant and the second largest planet in our solar system, Saturn. Named after the Roman god of wealth and liberation, Saturn is adorned with thousands of beautiful ringlets and is unique among the planets. Saturn has a hexagonal storm pattern around the North Pole. Like Jupiter, Saturn is made mostly of hydrogen and helium. Saturn has 53 known moons, among which is Titan, a world thought to be a prebiotic environment rich in complex organic compounds, possibly supporting life. The first planet found with the aid of a telescope is an ice giant, discovered in 1781 by William Herschel. Uranus is known as the sideways planet because it rotates on its side. Most of its mass is hot, dense fluid of icy materials, water, methane, and ammonia, above a small rocky core. Its atmosphere is made mostly of molecular hydrogen and atomic helium, with a small amount of methane. Uranus has 13 known rings and 27 known moons. No spacecraft has orbited this distant planet to study it at length and up close. The eighth and most distant planet in our solar system is another ice giant, more than 30 times as far from the Sun as Earth. Neptune is the only planet in our solar system not visible to the naked eye, and the first planet predicted by mathematics before its discovery. Neptune takes about 16 hours to rotate once on its axis, which is called a Neptunian day, and about 165 Earth years to orbit the Sun. Neptune has 14 known moons, and most likely cannot support life as we know it. And that is it. No more planets beyond the orbit of Neptune. There is, however, the dwarf planet Pluto. It is about half the width of the United States and orbits the Sun, about 5.8 billion kilometers away on average, about 40 times as far as Earth in a region called the Kuiper Belt. Pluto has five moons. The largest, Charon, is so big that Pluto and Charon orbit each other like a double planet. Pluto's surface gets as cold as minus 238 degrees Celsius. The dwarf planet has an almost heart-shaped glacier, blue skies, high mountains, and it snows, but the snow is red. Because of Pluto's elliptical orbit, the dwarf planet is sometimes closer to the Sun and us than Neptune is. But unlike the orbits of the planets, which lie mostly in the same flat disk around the Sun, the most distant region of our solar system is the Oort cloud. It is believed to be a giant spherical shell surrounding the rest of the solar system. It is like a big, thick-walled bubble made of icy pieces of space debris the size of mountains. The Oort cloud might contain billions, or even trillions, of objects, marking the, quote-unquote, edge of the solar system and the end of our space journey.
Thanks for watching.
Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.